Hi, I'm Doug, your tech support representative here at Atlantic British. In this video, we're going to talk about maybe the second step or a better step in approaching getting rid of the Three Amigos on your vehicle. Now, again, we've stated any ABS fault is going to activate the Three Amigos, which is essentially your ABS, your hill descent, and your traction control lights on the dash. But you use the fault codes to find out that, in fact, it is shuttle valve circuits that are creating the problem. Now, everybody refers to this as the shuttle valves, which in essence, it's not the shuttle valve itself, but it is the shuttle valve actuator. And this is the two actuators that plunge and operate the two valves. In addition to that, though, you have this intermediate block, which also has all the solenoids that activate and pull the valves open on the system. Now, what happens is, should we get a little brake fluid in there, or just due to exposure, the two pin connectors inside that block, which plugs into the shuttle valve actuator, can get some corrosion on it, as well as the connectors here. So after inspection and you see some corrosion in there, or you've pulled the shuttle valves apart, and I know there are some tests out there, you can test these to determine if they are good or bad, that you may want to do the two-piece set, which we have as a kit. So you might want to look into that. What we're going to do is we're going to show you, we've already shown you how to install the shuttle valve itself without disconnecting the brake lines. You can refer back to our video on that. But what we're going to do now is we're going to show you how to install this intermediate block. This also doesn't include removing the brake lines, which you basically can get around, and I'm going to show you how to do that. All right, so right away you'll notice that the solenoid block doesn't have any hydraulic lines going to it. So we actually should be able to replace this without having to disconnect any of the lines. Before we do that, though, we need to lift this block so that we can unbolt the shuttle valve actuator underneath, because that actually attaches electrically to the bottom side of this solenoid block. So first what we do is we'll start off with push that tab, and we pull the two electrical connectors. There's a little squeeze tab on the back side of this lower one, and that pulls that out. Get that out of the way, and even though it's really not necessary, we'll take the brake fluid level connector off just to move that out of the way, just so we know we're not going to damage the wiring. It's good to move that and get that clear. So you have three 10 millimeter nuts. The back ones you'll need to remove. The front one is in a slotted hole, so all we need to do with that is essentially just loosen it. Probably about 4 or 5 turns. And that should give us enough slack to remove that. And then we'll just take the two back ones out. Okay, so we've loosened that. We've taken the two rear out. We're going to lift the front. Now, take into account, these brake lines are bendable. All right? They're actually designed to be that way. So we should be able to lift this. We'll take that cup off so that we don't lose that. Come forward towards the engine. And then with a little arm, we'll lift that straight up. Now that'll give us access to the three bolts that hold the shuttle valve actuator in. We'll take those three out. I believe that's a number 25 Torx. Once those are out, this unplugs right out the bottom, and then we can set this down a little bit, take out the retainer bolts for the front of the solenoid block, and it'll be out in your hands. All right, just a note before I take the bolts out, it's a 5 millimeter hex driver, Allen drive, which is we actually referred to. Now you can get, and this makes the job a lot easier, this is actually a 3/8 socket driver with a 5 millimeter head on it, but you'll notice the way the tip is designed. And what this is for is that so you can get up at an angle and still remove the bolt and get a good bite. So like in the case where it's sort of hidden behind the two brake lines, you can still get in there, get a good solid bite, break it loose, and take it out. So essentially that's what we're going to do at this point. Now we're going to take this four on top, two on the bottom, and this block is going to slide right out. All right, so now that you've taken the four out of the top, we'll take the two out of the lower corners, but you'll find there is two more down in the bottom center, so you're going to have a total of 8 bolts to take out to remove this block. All right, so this is going to, once you've taken the bolts out, this is just going to slide right out of here. Now this might get in the way, so we're going to bend these brake lines up a little bit. And it drops right out. See, so you notice there's all your actuator rods for the solenoids. Nothing's going to drop out of there. Everything's going to stay in there nice and solid. So we'll set the old one aside. And we'll get a little bit of corrosion build up in there. And we'll put the new one in. Now before you do, run your finger around all of these posts and check for any fresh brake fluid. Should you get some, then that means you got a leaky valve and you're probably going to need to replace the block itself. This one seems relatively dry. You also want to make sure before you slide the new solenoid block on, you basically wiped away any possible debris or anything that got in there, because you want a nice tight fit when you install the new one. So then that's just going to involve, we lift a little bit and it slides right on. You get one of the bolts up in here in the top corner, and we'll just spin that in to hold the block in place, and then we can just put the rest of the bolts in. So now you've got the block in place, we've got all the bolts in, we've tightened the four on the bottom, and now we're going to install the actuator. You'll have to push up a little bit, but it'll go. And we'll just seat that in. You can feel the electrical connection seat in place, those two pins. And then we'll install the three bolts. And once we get that in place, then we'll put the block back down in its frame. All right, so what I'm going to suggest is when you put the block back on, you run the bolts in, tighten the four on the bottom, get them good and tight, lay the block in place, put the back studs in. You're going to angle this block, put the back studs in first, and then you can slide that boot and bell back over the stud on the solenoid block, pushing it forward, and that'll drop the one nut back in place. So now you can put the two nuts on. Once you've locked it in, it'll be a lot easier to tighten up those four bolts on top. Now, just as a note, Land Rover doesn't have a specific torque range for any of these bolts, either the nuts or the bolts, especially for the solenoid block. So you can determine basically how hard they were to get out. It will help you determine how much torque to put on them, putting them back in. And generally I do it by hand and it works very fine for me, but you may want to gauge how tight they are by how tight they were coming off. All right, so just to finish things off, you're going to make sure you put your two electrical connectors back on, plug in your brake fluid level connector, and at that point you're done. You didn't break the lines open, so we don't have to bleed the system. You may want to clear the codes out of the ABS module if you don't have that capability. Actually, what it will do is it won't necessarily clear the code, but it'll keep the light off if it sees that the system is functioning properly now at this point. If you should still end up with issues with the Three Amigos and they still come up as shuttle valve codes, then more than likely you're going to need the hydraulic unit. But we find for the majority of vehicles out there, this repair seems to take care of it. So when you're ready to take care of your shuttle valve issue and you find you need the extra component that this kit will help fix it for you, just call any of our knowledgeable salesmen at 1-800-533-2210, and thanks for watching.